I read a magazine called Viz. And it's like a comic for adults, basically. And they're kind of famous for having these like fake adverts in. And I saw this advert in it, and it made me really laugh. And then I kept seeing the same advert in Viz until I realised it was a genuine advert. It's for bald men, right? Now, there might be some bald men in the room. I don't care if you're bald. I'm not going to make fun of you. But see if this sounds like a good idea. It's called scalp micropigmentation, right? And it costs £5,000. What they do is they take the bald man into like a Harley Street clinic. They anaesthetize him, and then they get a tattoo gun, and they tattoo tens of thousands of dots all over his head. That's the technique. Does that sound like a good idea to anyone? Even in the advert, they advertise with like a before and after photo, and he looks genuinely angrier in the after photo. And they're like, a guaranteed look of hair. I'm like, that's not a guaranteed look of hair. That's like a guaranteed look that you've like fallen asleep at a playgroup. The thing that annoys me is like, it's all rubbish, you know. I see this advert on TV. It's for something called L'Oreal Anti-Aging Moisturising Cream. You've probably seen the advert yourself. And they're talking about the cream. They're holding the cream up. And there's like small print going along the bottom of the screen, you know. And it says something like, 89% of 136 women agree. So it's sort of like distracting you from the bullshit, you know, with like a maths problem. And it's like 119.9, like 120 women, but like one's got like a missing finger, think that the L'Oreal anti-aging moisturizing cream works. And it doesn't work. They prove in the advert it doesn't work because the face of L'Oreal anti-aging moisturising cream is the actress Andie MacDowall, and she has been the face of L'Oreal anti-aging moisturising cream for a period of 25 years, a period of time over which I have observed she has aged. She looks good, you know, don't get me wrong. Like I don't know what L'Oreal are doing with her in between the adverts, steeping her in a barrel of brine or laminating her every couple of weeks. She looks top class, you know, but she doesn't look like she has an age. It seems odd to me to choose the same woman to advertise anti-aging cream for like a quarter of a century. I had a guy heckling Edinburgh. He goes, oh, what they should have done is, after the first advert, they should have cryogenically frozen Andie MacDowall and then periodically defrosted her for subsequent adverts. I was like, mate, I know plastic surgery technology currently isn't great, but like cryogenic freezing is even worse. Like the first time they defrosted her, she'd be a dead woman. And he just went, well, he said she was a face. He didn't say she had to be alive. Can you imagine that ad camp? She's just like propped up on a table. There's like loads of alive women sat around her, someone like moving her a stick. People are like, oh yeah, I might buy the cream. She looks really peaceful.